Hi there. In our last section, you learned about how to graphically represent the data. In this section, you are going to talk about the central tendencies such as mean, median, and mode. So let's begin. Central tendency. The first vocabulary that we are going to talk about is mean or average. The mean or average of the observations is defined as the sum of all the observations divided by the total number of observations. The symbol to represent the mean is this symbol. We read it as a X bar. Now let's consider the explanation of mean or average. So let us consider n observations such as x1, x2, x3, dash dash, xn. Then the average or the mean is defined as x bar is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus dash 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 plus xn over n. If you want to represent this more mathematically, we will use a sigma function, which is basically a summation of the terms. So we will write x bar is equal to sigma, I is equal to 1 to n, xi over n. In other words, we can say that the mean or the average of any given observation is defined as the sum of all the observations divided by the total number that we are trying to find. The next vocabulary is mode. The mode is defined as the value that appears most often in a set of data. In other words, we can say that if we want to find the mode of the given data, what we need to do, we need to see which number or which value is coming the most, and that value will be the mode. The next vocabulary is median. The median is defined as the middle of all the observations of the given data. There are two cases for the median. So the case one is when the number of observations n is odd, then the median is the value of n plus 1 over 2th term, or basically n plus 1 over 2th observation. Case two, when the number of observations is even, then when we have n as even number of observations, then what we will do, we will add the two middle terms of the data and divide by 2, and whatever value we will get, that will be the median of the given data.